Hello, hello. My name is Rachel, and this is Ladle By Ladle. Welcome to my channel. Let's just talk. No script. Just me and my cats.
You've never really done yoga until you've done a Bikram class.
He was a teacher who was gonna make me perfect.
He saw potential in you that you might not see.
You are not intelligent, wise, experienced enough to understand who I am. It's not
over. I didn't really have a video topic for today, and I wasn't gonna post a video because I didn't have anything. Then I watched the Bikram documentary on Netflix this morning, and I was like, oh my god, I have thoughts. If you're unfamiliar, I guess let me just recap it real quick. So Bikram Yoga is a style of yoga named after Bikram Choudhury. Created this kind of, like, in my opinion, a cult of his particular brand of yoga. And it was really, really popular, I think all over the world, but definitely in the United States, for the last several decades. And it's only grown in popularity. And then he was outed as a sexual abuser and rapist by women who would go to his teacher training seminars. He's never really been criminally prosecuted, although he's been found guilty of many things in civil court, but he fled the United States like 2 or 3 years ago, and he's continuing to function as a yoga guru all over the world. The story is that this yoga guru, Bikram, is a horrible motherfucking person. Why am I care, you might ask. I was a student of Bikram Yoga for years. If you knew me between the ages of like 19 to like 23, then Bikram Yoga was like a huge part of my identity. I did Bikram Yoga once or twice a day, every single day for 3 years at least. And yeah, if I missed a day, I would do it twice the next day. And I was just obsessed with Bikram. I remember when I found out about all the allegations against him, which I think are true. I obviously believe all these women. It's really easy to see how this happened. I think he's definitely a terrible, horrible monster. And I remember hearing about it in like my senior year of college. So that would have been probably either 2014 or 2015. I had a roommate of mine who used to go with me sometimes send me a link to like a story about it. And I just, at the time, I remember being like totally shook by it. And I was actually working at the yoga studio. And I remember like bringing it up to them because we were like, originally it was Bikram Yoga Uptown New Orleans was the studio that I was practicing at that time. And yeah, they were also a little surprised. The woman that I worked for was also a little surprised and upset, and eventually changed the name of the yoga studio to just like Yoga Uptown, and then it was like Lotus Yoga Uptown. Either way, at that point I had switched to a different Bikram studio because I wanted Bikram, not the man, the practice. When I'm saying Bikram, I mean like the practice. I've never met the man in my life. I never went to a teacher training. So if you're looking for like additional like tea, like a supplemental information from the documentary, I'm not the right person to ask. I've never met the man. I totally believe all of the women who accuse him. And I stopped doing Bikram in 2016 completely. So yeah, so anyway, I just want to take you through my journey, how I think it impacted the way I view myself and my perspective of the like cult of Bikram from someone who was inside of it, but never like fully immersed. Like, I never went to yoga teacher training. When I was a teenager, I was a dancer. I love to dance. I still do. Because I wasn't gonna pursue it professionally, because I wasn't that good. I just liked to do it. I just needed an outlet where I could be like flexible and in tune with my body in a way that like dance had provided me with. And a couple people had mentioned that I should do yoga. And I was also becoming a little too extremely over the top interested in losing weight. And when I was Googling like yoga for weight loss, this is literally how I found Bikram Yoga. I Googled yoga for weight loss. Someone's like little, you know, early 2010s blog came up about how they did Bikram Yoga for 30 days and they lost like 50 pounds, something like totally unrealistic and unreasonable like that. And I was like, oh shit, that sounds awesome. I'd never done yoga. I'd never done hot yoga. Went to my first class, thought I was gonna die. This was when I was in New Hampshire. So my first ever class was with a really lovely woman named Jenny at Bikram Yoga Manchester, New Hampshire. And the class was really hard. I was sweating. I've never sweat so much in my life. I was wearing what I thought was an appropriate outfit, which was like yoga pants and a t-shirt, because that's what I thought you wore to yoga. Everyone around me was wearing essentially underwear and a bra. And that made so much sense because, like I said, I was dripping sweat. I could not hold most of the postures for the like length of time they wanted us to, and I sat down a lot. All of the staff were really encouraging, and they were like, that's how everyone's first class is. Don't give up. Keep coming back. Your body needs some time to adjust to the heat. And like, they were being so affirming and sweet, and I really want to be good at things. Like, if I start something, I don't usually often let myself quit it, and I also like strive to be the best. So I kept going. I had a tent. They give you a free 10-day thing. So I was like, might as well take advantage. Or like, it was $20 for 10 days. There we go. And so I was like, might as well take advantage of this. I only spent $20. I'm gonna go all 10 days. Why not? And by the end of the 10 days, I thought my life has been changed forever. On top of wanting to lose weight, which was like my number one reason for doing this, I also, I had, at that point in my life, extremely unexplained knee pain. I've been having severe knee pain since I was like 15. I'd been to a doctor's about it. I've been doing physical therapy for it. Nobody could tell me why. The best diagnosis that I'd ever gotten at that point in my life was that I had high arches and I wasn't wearing supportive shoes, which was giving me like knee and like sometimes hip pain because my alignment was off. Even though they told me that when I was like 17 and I always wore supportive shoes after that and my knee pain never went away, I just like learned to live with this extreme knee pain, which just this year I finally got a diagnosis that makes sense because pain has been creeping up into all of my joints and I'm only 26 years old and I have rheumatoid arthritis, which makes a lot of sense, but I did not know that at the time. They kept saying like, if you have knee problems, if you have hip problems, if you have joint problems, like this yoga, if you have anxiety, if you have insomnia, like if you have any of these issues, this yoga was created to solve all of your problems. And I just was like, holy shit, how is everybody not doing this? Because by the end of the first 10 days, I was completely used to the heat. And I was like, this yoga is gonna save my life. I fully believed it, 100%. I like started going every single day. I would get really agitated if I missed a day, like that I was like, there's this opportunity out there for me to be healing my body, and it would be a disservice to myself to not practice every single day. And I can't just do it on my own. I have to be in the studio because it has to be this like specific temperature, and I have to listen to this words, these words, this script that is still, even though I haven't been to a class in 3 years, like ingrained in my brain. Like they did a little pieces of the script in the documentary, and I was like triggered. I was like, oh my God, like I haven't heard that script in so long, and I can still tell you like almost every word to it. Because if you've never been to a Bikram class, every single class is the exact same. It's 26 postures and 2 breathing exercises done in the exact same order for the exact same length of time. It's a 90-minute class. There's no variation, all the way to the point that the instructors who had to have gone to this teacher training seminar are literally, they're not reading off of a script, but they're speaking from a memorized dialogue, the Bikram dialogue. I mean, it's all very strange. Now that I've done many other different types of yoga, it's really strange, but at the time I didn't know any better and I loved it. And I thought that, like I said, the yoga was gonna save my life. So I kept going and I became anorexic, and that kind of happens, you know, it happened to happen along the same timeline that I was becoming really obsessed with Bikram. I don't really know if I can blame Bikram yoga. What I will say is this, the class is done with floor-to-ceiling mirrors pretty much all around you. And it's not like a relaxing, like there's no like incense, there's no chanting, there's no any of the stuff that you might think of, like letting go of the ego and just like finding your breath and your body, like almost every other yoga practice I've ever been in. It's very, like, it's almost the opposite. Like, you're forced to stare full length at your body and analyze your positioning. There's no like calming meditative aspect of it. Although they say it's a 90-minute moving meditation, it feels like more of like a workout where they're yelling at you kind of thing. It's weird. It's not, I don't know how to explain it. But I think this, like, I was really in it. And so for 90 minutes or for 3 hours, if I did two a day, I was staring at my body in minimal clothing, comparing it to other women specifically, also wearing minimal clothing, who were extremely in shape, very flexible. I don't do this anymore, but at the time I was like super comparing myself to these other women, and I just wanted to be thin and strong like them. And I was forced to confront my fucking body every single day. So it's just a weird thing. Can I really blame Bikram? No, I put myself in that situation, and that was the situation that it was. Like, and to the credit of this class, I experienced a reduction in my knee pain in a way that I never have before, and haven't since, really. From what I knew about Bikram the man, well, the owner of the New Hampshire studio where I started my practice was related to him in some way. So there were I can't remember if she was his cousin or like niece or something, but either way, very nice lady, wonderful woman. But there were a lot of photographs of Bikram all over the studio. Of him doing like the iconic photographs of him doing the, I can't believe I just said iconic, the well-known photographs of him doing the 26 postures were all over the lobby. And obviously the thing is called Bikram, and I remember looking into, so many times I wanted to go to the teacher training, but it was like unbelievably expensive and I could never afford it. I used to work every summer and I couldn't afford to take a summer off to pay to go to this teacher training, even though I wanted to so badly. But I did so much research into it because I had almost every instructor I ever had and got close to was like, you must do it, you must go, it'll change your life, you won't even know, you'll feel amazing, you'll feel so much more connected to your practice, blah 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 blah. And then when I was watching the documentary, they were like, that's how it became like a closed loop system, is like they would find the people who were becoming dependent on the yoga, and then they would recommend them to go to the teacher training because you needed a recommendation from your instructor to go, which I always knew I was gonna have. Like, I remember being in college and thinking like, I would be so content to go to teacher training and then open up my own studio. Like, how amazing would that be? And then I could just practice all the time. I mean, this is how obsessed I was with it. Yeah, so I remember looking into like the legality of opening up your own studio, and that's when I was reading all this stuff about how like using the Bikram name requires like permission from like himself and his wife and his legal team, and he has to sign the lease, and like X amount of money goes to him. I was reading all of this stuff off of his website. It was all openly available, but I just remember thinking, is this cult? Like, I remember being like, is Bikram Yoga like a weird cult, and like these Bikram classes that I'm taking just like the money making endeavor of the cult? Like, cause I'm fascinated by cults, and I just remember kind of as I was getting really deep into like wanting to make Bikram Yoga something that I was potentially gonna do, I just remember thinking, wait a minute, I think this is a f***ing cult. And then it was around that time that my roommate sent me that link about him being a f***ing predator, and I just was like, holy sh**, this is the leader. I never really even thought about Bikram the man that much in this whole journey. I just remember like being really feeling a lot of gratitude for him for like inventing this. I thought he had invented this, and just like, I knew this dialogue by heart. I was so obsessed with the practice. I would like think about it all the time, how I was going to improve. I would feel it in my body, and I just thought that like Bikram Yoga was my calling in life. I mean, you guys don't understand, when you're committing 90 minutes to 3 hours a day to sit in a hot yoga room when you could be doing literally anything else with your life, like, it took a lot of dedication, and I thought that meant something. And I thought that like this yoga was really challenging me and changing me, and perhaps it did, but it also fueled like the most depraved parts of my mind. It fueled the idea that I needed to compare myself to other women. It fueled the idea that my body needed to look a certain way. It reinforced my insecurities by forcing myself to stare at my body, analyze my body, think about my body in different ways. And while, again, none of that is really the practice's fault, I mean, I had my own set of issues going on, it was definitely like a weird environment where it felt like every other woman kind of felt the same way that I did, but we were all in this together, which was weird. And yeah, so when I watched this Bikram documentary, I just really like, I understood in like a really deep and personal way the way that these women felt. Like when Sarah was saying that she told Bikram that he was better than chocolate, and that like that he had changed their lives, like I completely understand where they were coming from. He had created this cult because he had convinced us that he was healing us, and I really thought that he was. Like, when I was anorexic, I really thought that I was like doing the right thing for my body, and that I was super pure and clean, and that a big part of that was my yoga practice, my Bikram yoga practice. And I just remember thinking, like, with the pain decrease in my knees, which probably would have come from any form of regular stretching, by the way. When I watched the documentary, I just felt like I completely understood why these women felt like this practice had saved them. And there they were, staring at the man who invented it all. I mean, looking at it now, I'm just like, obviously he's a lunatic. But putting myself in my like 21, 22 year old shoes, I'm like, I would have done anything because I just was so grateful. And I thought that like my life's calling and my life's passion had been found through this yoga practice, which wasn't even really like what the foundation of yoga really is supposed to be, but I didn't know any better, you know? I was just this like stupid white girl that, but I wasn't stupid. I was really smart and I just somehow still got so wrapped up in perfecting this. I think that like Bikram yoga, the practice, it really like attracts people who are hardworking and need something, have something to prove, because it's a difficult fucking practice. I've dragged every single one of my friends and family members to it, and most of them fucking hate it, and they were like, why would you do this to yourself? And for me, it was just like, if you can conquer this heat and you can move through this heat, then you can do anything. And I really felt like that. I don't really know if I have a point other than I just like, I haven't thought about how intensely like ingrained Bikram yoga was in my identity for so long until I watched this freaking documentary this morning, and it just is making me feel like I had to talk about it. I don't know. The documentary is really good. It's on Netflix. You should look it up. Subscribe, like this video if you liked it, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.